Welcome to my kitchen, friends. Joy Bells here again. Bright Bells, Joy Bells. And I am here with another interesting seasoned rice recipe. Seasoned rice recipe. Okay? Jamaican style. And I'm gonna show you all that I will be putting in there today. Quick and simple. Okay, so I have paprika and garlic salt. I have bird peppers. I have four of them. A piece of onion. I have carrots. And I have some mini sweet peppers. And I have a piece of salt fish. Salted pullock to be exact. And rice, white rice, 2.5 cups, and some black pepper. And already I have my pan on the stove here, heating up, and I'm gonna add some oil. Friends, I will leave the measurements in the description for you, okay? Yes, but me, you know, Joy Bells love to eyeball, so I'm eyeballing, friends. And this is, I would say, roughly 2 tablespoons. And as you can see, it's hot, so I'm gonna move it over onto the other burner. But it's not so powerful like that front one there. And I'm gonna do it over there, and I'll say eyeballing, judging, roughly 2 tablespoons. And you want some more oil than usual because it's seasoned rice, you know, you're not gonna be eating meat from it and gravy with this, so that's a good amount of oil to use. Friends, I am not going to cook my salt fish before I fry it up. I'm gonna just rinse it because I want the most out of it. You can comment and tell me what you think. You can tell me how you do it. And I'm not using a big piece, friends. And I'm not cooking it before I put it there, okay? I'm using this piece, and all I'm gonna do is rinse it, chop it, add it to my oil, and you'll see. And I will get the most salt and all of that out of it. Alrighty? So I'm gonna rinse it over here in my sink. Just give it a little rinse. Carrots are still in my sink. Carrots. Just like that. And then I'm gonna give it a rough chop. Just a rough little chop. Nothing big. And the reason why I'm not cooking it, friends, I told you already, I'm gonna get the most flavor out of it that way. So I'm not cooking it before I fry it up. I will cook it with the rice to get that flavor. Okay, and this is skinless, boneless salt fish. Alrighty, yeah. But if you have the one with skin and bone, just go right ahead, take off the skin and make your seasoned rice, because it's tasty like that. I like it. I like to get those nice gooey gummy parts that you get from the ones that are not deboned. But I'm working with what is available in my area. So friends, that's what I'm doing. I'm gonna fry it up, and I'm not gonna let it get dry, okay? You see that? I'm gonna start moving it around, and then add my rice, because I don't want it to flavoring the oil, friends. Yeah, don't cook it cook it with the rice. Then you're gonna add your rice to it, friend. And some of you might be wondering, where is the sauce? Why isn't she using more? If you want to use more, go right ahead and use it. But I can tell you, this is very flavorful right here with this one little piece. If you want to use more, cook it before you add it to take out the salt. I am not using a lot, so I don't cook it before, so I get the most out of it. Alrighty. And on, this is on low heat, friends. Medium heat, rather. And just make sure that you mix that up well. Coat your rice like that in the oil and the fish. I'm already smelling it already. Yep. Yes, people, I'm smelling it already. Okay. And then what you do now, friends, this is where you can add coconut milk. Add what you want. You can add coconut milk or you can add water, okay? So you put in all your vegetables inside there. Chop them up and put them in. Season the pot. I'm not sure how much seasoning I want yet. I'm gonna kind of taste the oil. Do a little wipe in here. Clean up as I go along. Alrighty. Yes, friends. Yep. So now I tasted it and I think I'm gonna just add a little bit of garlic salt and paprika to it. And paprika will give it some taste, you know. So please don't, we'll give it color rather. If you don't want any color in there, if you just want that white color, don't use paprika. You can use other seasonings. Use any seasoning of your choice and make it to your liking, okay? Take the idea and make it to your liking, guys. Alright, my friends, so I'm gonna chop up my carrots really quick. And I'm cutting them on the diagonal. All my carrots are gonna go in now. Yes. Carrots going in. Uh-oh, I cut my red pepper by mistake. But anyway, I like the heat, so it's okay. I'm going to put in my veggies, friends, inside here. My onions. I'm going to chop my onion up. And I'm cutting it up, just the onion wedge I'm cutting up to put in there. Just add the amount of onion that you like to your liking. If you don't like a lot of onion, don't put it in there. You can even put scallion in there. Put some scallions if you like to use scallions, you know. Fix it up, take the idea and turn it into your own, or use it exactly how I gave it to you. It's okay. It's okay, friends. So that's it, friends. We don't want our saltfish to get all dry out, so, you know. We don't want it to fry crisp, you know. Yeah. See that, friends? Yep. Like that, and then add water or coconut milk and simmer it down. When it's halfway, add all your peppers on the top. When it's almost done cooking, put in, you can add your scotch bonnet pepper. I have bird pepper. I'm using bird pepper, okay? And I'm using mini sweet peppers, right? To pep up that a bit. You can put thyme in there, put a spring of thyme on top of it and simmer it down, my friends. Alrighty. Okay, so now I'm gonna add some water. And your water should cover like that. It mustn't be too much and it mustn't be too little. Just like that, my friends, and you've got you a nice salt fish meal for your family and friends. Just like that. And it's gonna be so tasty and delicious. Make yourself a pitcher of lemonade to go with this for dinner. Serve some dessert on the side and make dinner interesting. Yeah. Yes, friends. Yes, yes, yes. That's it. And you just leave that to simmer for 15 minutes. I'm gonna add a little black pepper before I cover it up, just a little bit. And leave it to simmer 15 minutes. Come back, add your hot pepper and your sweet pepper or whatever you wanna put in there. You could even cut up a potato and put in there. I'm sorry I didn't add a potato. It's very tasty with potato. Yeah, this season, salt fish season rice, very nice with carrots and potato. And I know that many of you have different season rice ideas. You can also comment and tell me about it. So don't be saying, oh, that's not how season rice is made, because we have many different variations. Alrighty, so listen to me, hum, while I wait until this rice is ready. Alrighty. And I know that it was the place where he abides. If you ask him, I know he has the answer. Child, child, you're standing on holy ground. Wow, it's very flavorful. I tasted it. Oh, it's very tasty. And a piece of butter will do well, friends. You can add a piece of butter. If you have pumpkin in your fridge, friends, oh my, just put you a nice piece of pumpkin inside there. Cut that pumpkin up and put it inside there, and it's gonna be lovely. Okay, we are standing on holy ground. Let us go. I sense his presence. And now I'm gonna add some more mini sweet pepper, friends. I just found some yellow ones, so I'm adding yet. So I'm gonna be now I have yellow, red, and orange instead of just red and orange, and my bird pepper, sweet pepper, and bird pepper. And I know that they are angels all around. Let us just praise Christ Jesus now. We are standing in His presence. We are standing in God's presence. I hope. To my little sweetie pie. Come here, baby. Come here. Give me a kiss. Where he? Hi. How are you? What's going on? Somebody wants to see what's going on, huh? That's what's going on. Okay. Let's go back in the room, okay? Come on, let's go. Let us just whisper. Okay, friends. So it's time for me to add my peppers. Sweet peppers, mini sweet peppers. And I have some bird peppers. To hot it up a little bit, and I'm gonna let this simmer for another 10 to 15 minutes, and then it's gonna be ready to be served. Alrighty. Okay, friends, don't forget to subscribe, like, and share. Until next time, it's Bright Bells, Joy Bells. Do good, live good, and most of all, love God. Ta-ta.